Hi, in this video, I am going to explain cash budget. So before you go for problem, let me explain what is the meaning of budget. See, generally in an organization, we'll have different departments. For example, sales department, purchase department, production department, stores department, finance department, personnel department. So these are the different departments functioning in an organization. So every department, they need to prepare budget. Budget means like forecasting the future. Okay, budget is just like a planning. Without planning, you cannot do anything. So planning is a very, very important. That is the first step in the organization. We have different types of budget. For example, sales budget, production budget, flexible budget, cash budget. So these are the different types of budget. So in this video, I'm going to explain only cash budget. So what is the meaning of cash budget? See, cash budget is an important budget. It estimates the amount of cash received and amount of cash payment and the balance of cash during a specific budgeted period. See, cash budget is based on forecast of cash or estimates of cash, showing what funds would be available at what times and whether the funds available would meet the requirement or not. So these are the things you can predict or you can forecast with the help of cash budget. So cash is a very important for every activity. You need to have a sufficient fund or sufficient cash. So in order to know the requirement of the cash and what are the source of cash for all these things, you need to prepare cash budget. So generally the budget can be prepared only with the help of past experience. Without past experience, you cannot project the future. So the future thing can be forecast or the future thing can be projected or expected or estimated with the help of past experience. So with the help of the past experience or past historical information, organization can project or organization can predict or forecast the future thing. It's called cash budget. So let me explain the basic concept of cash budget, how to prepare cash budget and what is the main objective of cash budget. See, the main objective of cash budget is to provide for all cash requirements in time and avoid accumulation of excess cash. The fund is very important to acquire the raw material. Timely payment is required for all the business activity. Cash is very important. They cannot simply accumulate the excess cash. So they need to find what is the exact requirement for the given period. For that, they need to prepare cash budget. So without preparing cash budget, they cannot able to know how much cash is required for the particular period. For that, they need to prepare cash budget. So when you prepare the cash budget, you have to start with the opening cash balance. The last month closing cash balance will be the opening cash balance for the current month. So current year closing cash balance will be the opening cash balance for next month. So in this way, you can prepare or you can find the opening balance and closing balance of cash. So first you have to start with the opening cash balance in the month, in the given month. And with the opening cash balance, you have to add all the receipt. So when you prepare the cash budget, you have to consider only the cash receipt for a particular period of time. That's all. The simple logic is you have to start with opening cash balance and add all the receipt made, all the receipt during a particular period of time, and you have to subtract the payment of cash. So what are all the expenses you have met, what are all the payments you have made for a particular month, that should be subtracted from the total receipt. So you have to start with opening cash balance and add all the receipt of cash. For example, what are the receipt of cash? First thing is cash sales. So sales can be two bases: cash basis, another one is credit basis. Cash basis means immediately you will get the cash from the customer. At the time of sale, immediately you will receive cash from the customer, is called cash sales. Credit sales means you sell the goods and you will receive the money from the customer later on, or after 1 week or after 1 month or after few days you will receive money from your customer. That is, postponing the receipt is called credit sales. See, when you sell your product on credit basis, later you'll receive cash from the debtors, and you have to record both cash sales as well as when you receive cash from your debtor, you have to find which date or which month you have received cash from the debtors. That can be identified from the information given in the problem, and that you have to add under receipt of cash. Okay, the first thing is cash sales. Next one, cash received from your debtors, and dividend received. Any receipt, any cash receipt will be recorded under this heading. That is dividend received, interest received, sale of fixed asset, issue of sales. So this is also one of the sources of fund. You can raise the fund from the public by way of issuing shares. And borrowings, you can borrow fund from the bank, like short term loans or long term loans or medium term loans. This is called as borrowings. So borrowing from the third parties or from the bankers also comes under receipt of cash. This is also one of the sources of cash. Then sale of investment. So sale of fixed asset as well as sale of any investment also one of the sources of cash receipt. So all the sources of cash receipt should be recorded under this head. So first you have to start with opening cash balance and add a receipt during a particular month. Then you'll get the total. So first you have to enter all the receipt and add along with the opening cash balance. You'll get total received during a month. Then you have to subtract all payments. Okay, so payment of cash. So what all the payment you have made during a particular month should be recorded here. That is, for example, cash purchase. So when you acquire the raw material, you'll pay the money immediately. You know, this is called as cash purchase. Credit purchase means you acquire the raw material, but you didn't pay the money immediately. This is called as credit purchase. But later on, you'll pay the money to your supplier. No, so on that time, you have to record payment to creditor. When you pay the amount to creditor in this particular month, means you have to record here. That is payment made to creditors, payment of wages, payment of expenses, payment of dividend, purchase of fixed asset. When you purchase fixed assets, you will make payment. No, this is also outflow of cash. That is payment. Payment of income tax, payment of bonus. So all cash payment should be recorded here under payment side. See, under the head of payment of cash. So just record all the payment. Now you'll get the total payment. No, you have started with the opening cash balance as on the given date and added all the receipt along with the opening cash balance. This is the total receipt. From total receipt, you have to subtract all payments. That is payment made during a particular month, that should be subtracted from the receipt. The balancing figure is called closing cash balance. So current month closing cash balance will be the opening cash balance for the next month. So after finding this value, you have to start with the you have to enter this amount here, and then again if any receipt during this particular month, you have to record here, and finally you'll get the total receipt for the month of May. And from this value, you have to subtract all payments made during the month of May. So any receipt during the month of May, that will be recorded here, and you have to add the receipt along with the opening cash balance. You will get the total receipt. From the total receipt, you have to record, you have to subtract payment made during the month of May. Then the balancing figure will be May month closing cash balance. So May month closing cash balance will be the opening cash balance for the month of June. For the month of June. Okay, again, after entering this value, just take the total of receipt. So total receipt during the month of June and add along with the opening value, you'll get the total receipt during the month of June. From this value, you have to subtract total payment, that is cash payment made during the month of June. Then you'll get the balancing figure in the month of June. So this closing balance will be the opening balance for July. In this way, you can prepare cash budget. So generally, the cash budget can be prepared with the help of past historical information. So this is only a planning or forecasting or estimating the cash position in the month of April, May and June. Now I'm going to explain how to prepare cash budget with the help of this illustration problem. Let me explain this problem first. From the following data, forecast the cash position at the end of April, May and June. They ask you to prepare cash budget only for 3 months, that is for the month of April, May and June 2015. This is the information regarding cash receipt and cash payment. So month information is given: February, March, April, May and June. Sales. Sales for the month of February 1 lakh, March 1 lakh 10,000, April 60,000, May 1 lakh 20, June 80,000. In the same way, purchase. February, March, April, May, June. Wages. Wages means payment made to laborer. This is also one of the payment or expense. Like that, sales expense, this is also payment. So here four information is given. Sales, it's a main sources of income. Receipt, this is purchase, payment. So when you purchase the raw material, you'll make payment. So this is the outflow of cash. This is payment. Wages also outflow of cash, so payment. Sales expense also outflow of cash, payment. But sales is the main sources of receipt or income. So this is the inflow of cash. So you have to start with opening cash balance and add the receipt and subtract all the payments in order to find the closing cash position. Here some additional information also given. Further information. Number one, sales at 10% realized in the month of sales. See, some information is given regarding sales. So every month they have some value for sales. No, February month 1 lakh, March 1 lakh 10th. This is the estimated information. With the help of the past historical data, they have given this information. So estimated sales for the month of February, March, April, May and June. All these informations are estimated only. So with this estimated figure, you are going to prepare cash budget for the month of April, May and June 2015. See, the first information is regarding sales. Sales at 10% realized in the month of sales. See, every month they have some value for sales. No, in that 10% realized in the month of sales itself, which means 10% sales are cash sales. Okay, the remaining 90% sales is credit sales. That is the 90% sales. The balance equally realized in two subsequent months, which means, for example, in the February month, you have sold 1 lakh rupees. No. So out of 1 lakh, only 10% realized in the same month. For example, 1 lakh, no. So in 1 lakh, 10% how much? 10,000 rupees. So 10,000 rupees cash sales is realized in the month of February month itself. How much the remaining balance? Remaining 90,000 is there. No, that 90,000 is called credit sales. That amount will be realized in two equal installments. That is, the balance equally realized in two subsequent month. Two subsequent month means the balance 90,000 will be realized in two equal installment in the two subsequent month. That is, that 90,000 will be divided into two. That is 45,000 and 45,000. The first installment will be realized in the month of March. The second 45,000 will be realized in the month of April. So this is the information regarding sales. This term is applicable. This condition is applicable for all sales. This is applicable for February month sales, March, April, May and June. Okay, in the same way, purchase. See, the information is regarding purchase. Purchases. So how much purchase? February 90, March 1 lakh. Some information is given now. Look at this information. Purchase. Creditors are paid in the month following the month of supply. See, the entire, they didn't give any information about the cash payment for purchase. The entire purchases are credit purchase. Okay, see, creditors are paid in the month following the month of supply. Who is the creditor? The person one who provided the raw material to us without receiving any money. They are called as creditor. So now we have purchased the raw material from the supplier, from the creditor. We didn't pay the money immediately. So we are going to pay the month. We are going to pay the money in the month following the month of supply. That is, we have purchased 90,000 worth of raw material in the month of February, but that amount will be payable in the month of March. So in the month of March, we have acquired 1 lakh value of raw material from our supplier, from our creditor, but we have made payment only in the month of April. In the same way, April month 1,10,000 rupees value of purchase we have made, and we have paid only in the month of May. In the same way, the creditors are paid in the month following the month of supply, means 1 month lag payment. In the same way, third information is regarding wages. So regarding wages is 20% paid in arrears in the following month, which means 80% of wages paid in the same month. The remaining 20% will be payable in the following month. Following month means next month, which means arrears. Okay, so according to this term, you have to find out the payment made to laborer, that is wages. Next, fourth information is sales expenses paid in the month itself. That is, the information is given regarding sales. No, this is the value you are going to pay in the same month. February 2500 paid in the same month itself. There will be no lag in payment. In the same way, March month payment will be made in the month of March itself. All the sales expenses will be paid in the same month. That is, sales expense paid in the month itself. There will be no lag payment. Next, income tax 30,000 payable in June. Okay, so this information, this payment you are going to make only in the month of June. So this will be recorded only in the month of June. Next, dividend 12,000 rupees payable, that is payment in the month of June. So this information also recorded only in the month of June. Next one, income from investment, that is you are going to receive 5,000 rupees half yearly in the month of March and in the month of September. So this information is irrelevant information. Why? Because you are going to prepare cash budget only for 3 months, that is April, May and June. This income you are going to receive in the month of March and September. Last information is cash balance as on 1st April 2015, that is cash balance on hand as on 1st April 2015, 50,000. This is the opening cash balance. Now look at this sentence. From the following data, forecast the cash position at the end of April, May and June. I told you, no, when you prepare the cash budget, you have to start with the opening cash balance for the first month, that is April month. You need to have an opening cash balance. So without having the opening cash balance, you cannot prepare the cash budget. So this information is given in this problem. Cash balance as on 1st April 2015, 50,000. So now let us see the solution. Cash budget for 3 months ending June 2015. Okay, see this problem. They ask you to prepare cash budget for the month of April, May and June. But in the problem, they have given 5 month information. Okay, but you have to prepare only for April month, May month and June month 2015. Okay, so particular problem, April, May and June. I told you, no, you have to start with opening cash balance. Opening balance of cash is given in the problem. See this from last information. Cash balance on hand as on 1st April 2015, 50,000. So enter 50,000. This is the opening balance as on 1st April 2015. You have started with the opening cash balance. Now you have to add all receipt. Receipts of cash, that is inflow of cash. So any inflow of cash or any cash receipt that should be recorded here, and you have to add along with the opening cash balance in order to find the total receipt. After finding the total receipt, the next step is you need to subtract all the payment from the total receipt in order to find out the closing cash balance. Very, very simple logic. You have to start with opening cash balance and add the receipt. Receipt means inflow of cash during this particular month, and find the total receipt. From the total receipt, you have to subtract total payment made during this particular month to know the closing cash balance for this particular month. After finding the closing cash balance for the month of April, then you can transfer that amount to next month, because current year closing balance will be the opening balance for next month. Okay, in the same way you can prepare cash budget. And now you have started opening cash balance for the month of April, and now you have to add receipt of cash during this particular month. Now look at the problem. See, the first information is, so in this problem, sales is the main sources of receipt. All these three informations are payment information. So now we have to focus only this information. Sales at 10% realized in the month of sales. So now we have to work out the working note. Sales at 10% realized in the month of sales. Okay, which means 10% sales are cash sales. So first you have to record cash sales. First information is cash sales. So cash sales means when you sell the raw material, immediately receive money from your customer is called cash sales. Credit sales means postponing the receipt is called credit sales. So according to this information, only 10% of sales realized in the month of sales, which means only 10% is cash sales. Now you have to find only April month cash sales, May month cash sales and June month cash sales. Now look at the sales figure. April month, how much you have sold? 60,000. So out of 60,000, only 10% realized in the same month. So you have to record 6,000 in the month of April. So cash sales only 6,000 in the month of April. In the month of total sales 120,000. So out of 120,000, only 10% realized in the same month. So how much one in 120,000 10%? 12,000 rupees. So May month cash sales 12,000 rupees. In the same way, June month how much? 80,000 total sales. Out of 80,000, how much 10%? 8,000 cash sales realized. That is sales at 10% realized in the month of sales. That is, in the same month you have received only 10% of total sales. So 80% 10% is 8,000. In the month of June, cash sales how much? 8,000. That's all. Cash sales is over. So what about the remaining amount? See, sales are 10% realized in the month of sales and the balance, okay, out of 100%, only 10% is cash sales. The remaining 90% are credit sales. That is, the balance 90% equally realized in two subsequent months. The remaining 90% amount will be realized in two installment, in two equal installment in the subsequent 2 months. Now, for this information, you need to prepare working note. See, only 10% of sales is cash sales you have realized in the same month. So remaining amount you are going to realize in the subsequent 2 months. That is, cash received from debtors. Debtors means your customer. So you are going to receive cash from your customer. No. So some information is given. For that you have to work out working note. Okay. You have to do the working note one to know the collection for sales. So particular column February, March, April, May and June. Just write the total sales. So what is the total sales for the month of February? February 1 lakh. March 1,10,000. April 60,000. May 1,20,000. June 80,000. In that, only 10% realized in the month of sales. Okay, so plus cash sales. 10% of the same month. So out of 1 lakh, 10%, 10,000. Balance 90,000. Credit sales. In the same way, for the month of March, out of 1 lakh, 10,000. What is 10%? 11,000. Balance 99,000. Credit sales. In the same way, out of 60,000, 10% is 6,000 realized in the same month. The remaining 54,000 credit sales. In the same way, 1,20,000, 12,000 rupees cash sales. Remaining 1,08,000 credit sales. 80,000, 8,000 rupees cash sales, remaining 72,000 credit sales. So now you have got credit sales. Now see this adjustment. Sales 10% realized in the month of sales. In the same month you have realized 10%. The remaining amount is called credit sales. So they have given some information about the credit sales. See the balance, that is, this is the balance is called credit sales. So this balance equally realized in two subsequent months. So they are going to realize the balancing amount, the balance credit sales, in two installment in the subsequent month. In the subsequent month means February you have sold 1 lakh. No, for that you have realized only 10%. That is 10,000 rupees you have realized in the same month. The remaining 90,000 you are going to realize in the subsequent 2 month. Subsequent 2 month means next 2 month. This 90,000 you are going to realize in two installment, that is 45 and 45. That is, the first 45 you are going to realize in the month of March. The next 45 you are going to realize in the month of April. Okay, so for that you have to write like this. First installment and second installment. See, after the credit sale, the first installment is next month. This is 90,000. No, so the 90,000 is the balance amount is equally realized in two equal installment. No, so just divide this into two. 90,000, 45,000 and 45,000. The first installment they are going to receive in the month of March, 45,000. The second installment they are going to realize in the month of April. So this is the way. So out of 1 lakh, they have realized 10,000 rupees immediately in the same month itself. The remaining 90,000 they are going to realize in the subsequent 2 month. Subsequent 2 month means the next 2 month. So first installment and second installment, total 90,000 they have realized in the 2 subsequent month. In the same way, the second March month 99,000, they are going to realize in 2 equal installment for the 2 subsequent, for the 2 next month. 49,500. And 49,500. So first installment in the month of April, that is 99 divided by 2, the first installment in the month of April, the next installment you are going to receive in the month of May. First month 90,000 you have realized in the month of March, and in the next installment you have realized in the month of April. In the same way, the March month 99,000 credit sales you are going to realize in two equal installment. The first installment is 49,500, second installment is 49,500. In the same way, third April month credit sales you are going to realize in two subsequent months. The first installment is 27,000, second installment 27,000. So this is the two installment you are going to receive. In the same way, May month amount, your total credit sales amount is 1,08,000. The first installment will be 54,000 in the month of June. The remaining 54,000 you are going to receive in the month of July. But this information is not required. Why? Because they ask you to prepare budget for April, May and June. Just ignore the other information. Now you have to find the total amount, how much you are going to receive from the customer in the month of April, in the month of May and in the month of June. Just take this total. 49,500 plus 45,000, 94,500. In the month of May, how much amount you are going to receive from the customer? 27,000 plus 49,500. 76,500. Okay, so you are going to receive 54 and 27 in the month of June. 1,000. Okay, so this information you need not find. You need not find any total for the month of February and March. In the same way, you need not find any amount for July. Why? Because you are preparing cash budget only for 3 months. The two, April, May and June. So you need to find how much amount you are going to collect from the customer in the month of April, in the month of May and in the month of June, according to the information given in this problem. Okay, now come to the answer. That is, in the cash budget, you have started opening cash balance and you have entered cash receipt, that is cash sales you have entered for 3 months, and now you have to record cash received from debtors. Okay, just refer the working note. So April month, how much amount you are going to receive from your debtors? 94,500. In the month of May, how much amount you are going to receive? 76,500. In the month of June, 81,000 you are going to receive from your customer. So 81,000. So this is the information you can take from the working note, that is cash received from debtor for 3 different months. Now you have recorded the information regarding sales. So this information is over. Now go for the second one. Purchases. This is the payment. Okay. So purchases, that is creditors. See, when you purchase raw material from your supplier on credit basis, they are called as creditor. You had to pay money to the supplier. They are called as creditor. Okay. You are due to supplier. You are due to creditor. See, the creditors are paid in the month following the month of supply. See, you have purchased raw material from the supplier on credit basis and you are going to make payment in the following the month of supply. Following the month of supply means in the month of February you have purchased 90,000 value of raw material, but you are going to make payment in the next month. Following the month of supply means next month. You are going to make payment of 90,000 only in the month of March. March month purchase 1 lakh rupee, you are going to make payment in the month of April. April month you have acquired 1,10,000 value of purchase, value of raw material, but you are going to make payment in the month of May. May month you have acquired 1,15,000 value of raw material, but you are going to make payment in the month of June. So this is the procedure according to the information given in this problem. So purchases are, the creditors are paid in the month following the month of supply. You have to record this information under payment side. So all the payments should be subtracted from here, from this value. So payments, payment made to creditor for purchases. You have purchased the raw material. Now you are going to make payment. You are preparing cash budget only for 3 months, no, April, May and June. Okay, see, the purchases, creditors are paid in the month of, in the month following the month of supply. Okay, so in the 90,000 you are going to pay in the month of March. March month purchase you are going to make payment in the month of April. So you are going to prepare, you are preparing budget for April, May and June. No, so you have to record in the month of April. So April month you have purchased 1,10,000 rupees value of raw material. No, but in the month of April you will pay the previous year purchase. The March month purchase amount will be payable in the month of April. So now you have to record only in this value, 1 lakh. That is March month purchase amount will be payable in the month of April. April month, how much amount you have purchased raw material worth is 1,10,000 rupees. So this amount you are going to make payment in the month of May, 1,10,000. So this is over. This is also over. May month, you have purchased 1,15,000. So this amount you are going to make payment in the month of June. So June payment is, June month you are going to pay 1,15,000. That is March month purchase payable in the month of April. April month purchase payable in the month of May. May month purchase payable in the month of June. So according to the information given in this problem, you have recorded this. Next one, wages. So wages also payment. See, look at this information. 20% paid in arrears in the following month, which means wages. Okay, so out of the total wages, 80% paid in the month itself, the remaining 20% paid in arrears in the following month, that is 1 month lag payment. So 80% wages paid in the same month, the remaining 20% payable in the next month as arrears. So you have to record under payments, wages, current month 80%, the remaining 20% arrears. Arrears 20% payable in next month. See, April month, you have to focus only these 3 months, April month. So how much April month wages, how much? 7,000. So out of 7,000, 80% paid in the same month, 20% paid in arrears. Okay, they have given information regarding the arrears. You need to assume the remaining 80% paid in the same month. So just find 80% on 7,000, 5,600. So April month, what is the total wages 7000, in that 80% paid in the same month, the remaining 20% payable in the next month, okay, that is May month. Okay, so what is the 20% on 7000? 1400. In the same way, wages for the month of May, how much? 10,500. Just find 80% on 10,500. 8,400 payable in the same month. The remaining 20% payable in the month of June, that is next month, 2,100 arrears. Okay, now just look at the previous month. Previous month, so you are preparing budget. You are preparing cash budget from April. No, just look at the previous month. So March month, your March month 11,000 rupees wages, total expenses is 11,000. In that, 80% received in the same month, the remaining 20% on 11,000, that amount you are going to pay in the month of April. So you have to find 20% on this and record the 20% in the month of April. 2,200, that amount you are going to pay in the month of April. Okay, in the same way, June month. So June month, how much? So you have recorded April, May, you have recorded. June month, what is the total wages? 8,500. You need to find 80% on this, because you are going to make payment in the same month. What is the 80% on 8,500? 6,800. Okay, the remaining 20% you are going to make payment in the month of July. So that information is not relevant. Why? Because you are preparing only for 3 months, starting from April to June. So far we have recorded sales, purchase, wages. What is the next information? Sales expenses paid in the month itself, which means which is paid in the same month itself. So there will be no lag in payment. Just see the sales expense for the relevant month and record that amount under payment. See April month, what is the sales expense? 2000 rupees. No, so just record in the same month. Sales expenses, how much? April month 2000, May month 3000, June month 2200. So there will be no lag in payment. Next one is income tax. This is also payment. Okay, so income tax 30,000 payable in the month of June. Okay, so this amount is only you are going to record in the month of June. Income tax, how much? Only you are going to record in the month of June. How much? 30,000. This information you record. Next one, dividend 12,000 payable in June. This is also payment, that too only in the month of June. How much? 12,000. Next. Income from investment 5,000 received half yearly in March and September. This is the income. This amount should be recorded in receipt. Along with the opening balance, you have to add the receipt. But here, this amount you are going to receive twice in a year. That is in the month of March and in the month of September. But we are preparing budget for April, May and June, but this receipt in the month of March and September. So this information is irrelevant information. You need not record this information in April, May or June. Just ignore it, leave it. Next, cash balance. So you have started with opening cash balance in the month of April. Okay, you have started 50,000. Now just find the total opening cash balance and add receipt for the first month. That is in the April month, you have to find the total receipt. So what is the total receipt? 1,50,500. Okay, you need not find the total for May and June immediately. First, you need to find the total receipt for the first month and then find the total of payment. Then, subtract the total payment from the total receipt to find the closing cash balance. After finding the closing cash balance for the first month, then you can transfer this amount to next month. That is, the current year closing balance will be the opening balance for next month. After entering the opening balance for the month of May, then you can find the total receipt, then you can subtract the total payment to find the closing balance for the second month. And after finding the second month closing balance, then you can transfer that amount to next month, that is in the month of June. The opening balance will be there, then you can find the total receipt, then you can subtract the total payment to know the closing cash balance in the month of June. So first you have to you got the total receipt. No, now take the total payment. This is total receipt, right? Receipt. This is A. Total A denotes total receipt. Now find the total payment. B denotes total payment. Just find the total. 1,09,800. Now find the closing cash balance. How you'll find the closing balance? Just take A value and subtract B from A to know the closing balance. That is total receipt. How you got this value? You started with opening cash balance and added the total receipt for the month of April, and you got the total receipt in the month of April. From this value, you have to subtract the total payments made during this particular month. So A minus B will be your closing cash balance, 40,700. This is a closing cash balance for the month of April. This will be your opening cash balance for the next month. Now just record 40,700. Now get the total receipt value. Find the total. 1,29,200. Okay, so after finding this, just take the total payment value. 1,22,800. Now you got the total payment for the month of May. Now subtract from receipt to payment. So total receipt, how much? 1,29,200. From total receipt, subtract total payment. So what is the balancing figure? 6,400. So this is the closing cash balance in the month of May. After finding this, you can transfer this amount to next month. June month, 6,400. After entering this value, now you can find the total receipt. Just take the total, 95,400. So after finding the total receipt for the month of June, now you have to take the total payment for the month of June. That is 1,15,000, wages 6,000, current year wages 6,800, and arrears 2,100, sales expense 2,200. I have wrongly written 2,000, but the sales expenses, June month sales expense 2,200. Okay, just correct it. 2,200, and income tax 30,000, dividend 12,000. Just find the total value, total payment, 1,68,100. Now subtract the total payment from the total receipt. So in the month of June, you have got minus 72,700, which means overdraft. So if we get plus value, favorable value means you'll have closing cash balance. So according to the information given in the problem, you'll have closing balance in the month of April, and you'll have closing balance in the month of May, 6,400 in the month of May. But in the month of June, you'll have overdraft. So minus negative figure means, so your receipt is only 95,400, but your required 1,68,800 rupees payment. So these are the payment amount is required. So how will make payment? Because you have only lesser amount than the payment. You have only 95,400 as receipt. So out of this amount, you cannot make this much of payment. So what is the result? So you are going to withdraw excess amount than the actual actual balance. So this amount will be called as overdraft. So you can avail this facility from your banker. That is, overdraft means withdrawing excess amount than the actual balancing figure in your account is called overdraft. So this is one of the facility or financial aid which can be given by the banker to their customer, that is current account holder. Negative value which denotes overdraft. Hope you could understand this video. If you really like this, please leave your comments and kindly share and like.